Yeah, got a new show for y'all.
Got a damn good show, Keith. Got a damn good show.
All right, so The View, that's a outstanding journalism, and that's mainstream media right there. And that whole Epstein, those documents getting released, they talked about it. I said, man, I got to hear what these top-tier journalists got to say about this whole Epstein situation. Because these are top-tier journalists over there.
Man, these women are talentless. Whoopi, she's an actor. But the other one, Whoopi, she's just pretending to be stupid because she's an actor. The other ones, they're not pretending.
That was a good one. I like that.
You like that?
I like that.
You like that sentiment I just shared, that point of view, that perspective?
Yeah, that stance.
It was spot on. I hit the nail right on the head.
So Whoopi's not stupid. She's just acting. No, they just stupid.
They just plain stupid.
All right, but anyway, so
stupid and can read and follow directions. That's hard to find. So they do have some talent, you know? It's hard to find somebody stupid that can follow directions.
Yeah. All right, so I like, before I get to the clip, I like how they make it, they politicize it,
mm-hmm.
and they turn it around, and it's like they're like throwing shade at Republicans.
Yeah.
Hold up.
Why are you so slow and methodical?
It's like they're trying to.
What they trying to do, Keith? You're killing me over here.
They're trying to put Republicans in a bad light. And you're talking about Jeffrey Epstein.
Yeah. Keep.
What do Republicans got to do with this?
Let me just do some talking. That's the whole purpose of the show. That's the only reason why this show is on TV. They're plants. Right? Whoopi, she's a talented plant. Right? Like I was saying, she can act. She's a smart woman. I think she let her biases dictate how she's thinking. It clouds her judgment significantly. But the others, they can't help it. They lack the capacity. So what I'm trying to say, the whole purpose of that show is to garner and what's women for? Indoctrinate its viewers.
Yeah, spread that Democrat propaganda.
The only reason why this show is they need to galvanize people to vote Democrat.
Yeah.
The only reason why this show is on TV is to put Republicans in a bad light.
All right, let's go to the video. Let's go to the first video.
But something that I have a bit of a hard time with, and I'm going to be careful, so try and lawyer if I get this wrong, but listen, there's a lot on the far right who want to wish cast these liberal elites being part of the Epstein things. We know Bill Clinton's name has come up, but no wrongdoing has been alleged. But Donald Trump's name has also come up. I do remember being at the White House when Ghislaine Maxwell was arrested, and Donald Trump said, I wish her well. And afterward, I ran back to his office. I said, you need to walk that back. And he didn't. He doubled down.
Now, I agree with you on the whole Ghislaine Maxwell thing. I have no idea what Trump said. Wish you well.
It's like
wishing Hitler well. Why would you do that?
See, you're falling right into the left's trap. I thought she was smarter than this. You're supposed to be a conservative.
I'm not a damn zealot neither.
Well, just pay attention. Let me do some talking. Maybe Trump said that because he didn't have all the facts.
Keith,
think about it. Man, that dude's a child molester? Wow, I bet you Miss Maxwell is devastated. You see what I'm saying? Maybe they have all the facts. Maybe he didn't know she was involved.
Okay.
That could be a possibility. Am I right or wrong?
You're right.
Am I right or wrong?
But...
You're
right.
Am I right or wrong?
You're right.
But
Trump is a sharp guy. He was president at the time. He should have known better.
But Trump is a sharp guy, says a lot of stupid things. Like that whole thing went down with the KKK in Charlottesville, the statue. Oh, it was good people on both sides.
I know what
he meant.
Yeah.
But you know black people ain't got the capacity to understand what he's saying.
Hey, man, you need to.
What Trump needs to do is when he talks, he can't speak on the same level as intellectuals. You got to speak down to people.
Right.
So when you say stuff like, man, it was good people on both sides, what is a dumb Negro going to think? Oh, man, I told you he was racist. Like, Like, when Trump said it was both people on good sides, it was true, but you shouldn't say things like that. Like you had the white supremacists there. They wanted the monuments to stay up, right?
Right.
Then you had other people, for historical value, it wasn't a white supremacist. They wanted the statues to stay up.
Yeah.
There was okay. good people yeah, okay. on both sides.
Yeah, but, yeah.
You had Antifa, you had white supremacists, you had people that there was
okay,
that.
I'm not talking about the statues.
Historically, I'm just saying.
All right, man, let's get off the statue. I'm getting back to this.
I'm just letting everybody know my perspective. I want them to understand the sentiment that I'm trying to share. Okay?
Okay.
Now, when he said, man, I wish her well, that's the same. I could put it to you like this. Like, when you find out you your husband's running a, let's just say, someone finds out that her husband has been having an affair, but not only is he having an affair, that the person was underage. Man, I wish his wife well, you know? You might say something like that. That's the only thing I could come up with,
hey, Kevin,
why he would say that.
Yeah, okay, I'm thinking maybe he didn't have all the facts, but at the time she was arrested for being his right-hand man, Epstein.
I don't think so.
What?
He was arrested at the same time?
She'd been charged and everything. This is
when Trump was in the White House.
Yes.
Who was charged first?
Epstein was, Kevin, but she was being charged.
Like I said the first time, maybe he didn't have all the facts.
All right, I'm done talking about it. Now, she doesn't want to make this.
Hey, Keith. Hey, let me do some more talking. Hey, look, this is crazy, right? This is crazy, the whole Epstein thing. They both sides, right, trying to politicize it for their own game. They're trying to twist people's perception of what really would happen. Now, there's a lot of movie stars, a lot of actors. They keep denying the fact that Bill Clinton was on there. But they, for some odd reason, yeah, they're trying to link Trump with this.
Yeah, this is my point I was trying to get at. If you shut up and let me do some talking, it's my time to shine now.
Like what?
Hey, Kevin.
No, man.
You need to stop putting
you
me on.
Talk too slow. Man, go ahead and tell him.
Hey, Kevin, stop messing up my rhythm, man. I'm all about rhythm over here.
I did.
See, I see what you did when you brought up Trump and Clinton. Like, you're trying to protect Clinton by saying, well, Trump was there, too. Was Clinton on that flight log as many times as Clinton? Mm-hmm. Clinton was down there every weekend, pretty much. You had Trump, what, once?
Trump
and it didn't even
Trump.
Go to the island, hey, but hey. You're going to put him in. Shut up.
Hey, Bill Clinton.
Hey, let me do some talking.
Bill Clinton had a seat on that plane that said Bill Clinton. He was on that damn plane so much.
But you're going to put Trump in the same boat as Clinton? Clinton, shut up. You go in Epstein's house. Clinton in a damn oil painting in a damn blue dress. But you're going to put him in the same boat as Trump?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's what I've been trying to say all along. That's why that show's on TV. They don't care about the truth. They can't handle the truth. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They're there. The only reason why this show's on TV is to twist everybody's perception of what really happened. They gaslighting everybody for their own political game. This show is fake. It's fake news. It's fake news.
You're going to throw Trump under the bus for them, I think was very naive something to say about Maxwell. But you won't point out the fact that Clinton was on that damn plane like every weekend. I'm talking metaphorically, but you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
All right, there's another video to this.
No,
this is the icing on the cake here.
Oh, it gets even stupider, huh?
Oh, man. This is icing on the cake. Not only is it icing on the cake, they're going to put a cherry on that bitch.
They putting a cherry on top?
Put a cherry on it. And then they ain't done. You know what they did?
Put some whipped cream
on it? They put some whipped cream on that bitch. Let's go to video.
It's that time, Whoopi. I mean, look at what's happening with these anti-vax people. You know, I said this the other day. I have been boosted and boosted and boosted, so I got it COVID. It does not prevent you from getting COVID, but you don't die from it.
Right.
And yet you have people like this Robert Kennedy Jr. who's going out there and attacking Fauci and
he's
saying that it's a bad thing to get the
booster. He's not saying it's satire. He's actually believing
it. Well, I know, but this is fake news. And that's another thing. Fake news, alternative facts, all of that started recently.
And to that point, people need to check their sources. I mean,
we
only listen to what we say. I'm telling you. We tell the truth.
Maybe that.
You know what she said then?
You need to check your source.
And then she says, you need to listen to us. Okay, so remember when the vax came out?
Yeah.
Oh, it keeps you from getting it.
Yeah.
Keeps you from spreading it.
Yeah.
Then it came out, it said, hold up. You can still get it. You can still spread it, but it's going to keep you from dying from it. Do you seriously think people who are fully vaccinated and boosted, none of them are succumbing to COVID? Matter of fact, in Australia, I remember... Remember Australia?
Yeah.
They locked everybody down. They was having press conferences every day. 10 died, 8 of them was vaccinated, 2 of them was unvaccinated.
Yeah.
Then they cut all of that out because people's like, why am I getting vaccinated and these people are still dying from it?
Yeah.
You actually believe people who are vaccinated and boosted are still are not dying from COVID?
They're immune. And then you telling everybody to check their sources. What the hell? Where you? What source? What is your source? That's crazy. To tell people, millions of people, if you take this vaccine, you boosted, you are not going to die from COVID.
If that's the... need to check your sources, everybody, but you can listen to us.
Doshi is stupid. I mean, she's that stupid. She that stupid that don't know she's stupid.
Yeah.
But she's telling her own way because it's hard to find a stupid person that knows how to follow directions and push a good narrative.
Damn good show. Hey, we got a new giveaway going. Give away a Ford F-350 and 10,000 carats. The end of the win. Go to fishhawkstwins.com. Anything you buy from the site, get you automatically into the win. Yeah.